Howdy, howdy, neighbors. This is DJ Davenport, welcoming you and yours to Access to Bluegrass, a bluegrass show brought to you every week at this time by this station. And here is a fine bluegrass band playing their little hearts out for you. And with no further ado, here they are.
Yes, I've lived a lot in my time. Well, I fought the Grim Reaper down in the dark valley. I prayed her sun couldn't shine. I've looked through the bars of that cold, lonely prison. Yes, I've lived a lot in my time. Yes, I've lived a lot in my time. Oh, I fought the green creature down in the dark valley, afraid where sun wouldn't shine. I looked through the bars of that cold, lonely prison. Yes, I've lived a lot in my time. Who can say just how it starts? Angry words and broken hearts. Too silently we sit apart. You and I. In a while the anger's gone, and we forget who's right or wrong, and none of us can end it all with just a smile. We believe in happy endings, never breaking, only mending, taking time enough the hurt inside. We believe in new beginnings, giving in and forgiving. We believe in happy endings, you and I. So we cling together now and wonder why we're all so proud, when all that matters anyhow is our love. We believe in happy endings, never breaking, only bending, taking time. Hurt inside. We believe in new beginnings, giving in and forgiving. We believe in happy endings, you and I. Thank you. Thank you a lot. We really appreciate having the paid studio audience here. Former members of the Peanut Gallery, some of them. Some might not be that old. And it's always a wonderment that you would have bluegrass music on television, because without you had Devil Begotten, Pimple Be Ridden, Hair Beside Maggot Infested, Snot Encrusted Rock and Roll Singers, you couldn't find uglier people than bluegrass people. So let's make a video of them. Let's put it on television. And this is a fine studio here. They actually brought in a lady, you know, because whenever you have bluegrass music, you got to have that pained expression on your face. And they brought in somebody to beat us up, just in case we wasn't going to look miserable enough whenever we sung these songs. In fact, that put me in the mood for a song here. This particular song is a metaphor, and I know I shouldn't use a word like that in front of the bluegrass audience without maybe use it in a sentence. I don't know that personally of my own recognizance, but my good friend John Duffy, who knew all about English literature and grammar and stuff, told me you can't use words that the audience don't know, which is a good reason not to use any of them. And so I was trying to think of a sentence. John Duffy, first one ever taught me, actually, that feminist only had one E in it. And so I guess up till then I'd been saying things incorrectly when I pointed out that some of the California bluegrass musicians were feminer than the TV preachers. But I was trying to think of a sentence here on the way to the television place, and all I could think of was I was getting so old I couldn't remember what a metaphor. But then I remembered, just right before I left home, my old stallion, he's 27 years old, you know, but he thinks he's two when spring comes, because I got a beautiful mare right across the fence from him, and he was down there the other day looking over, you know, had that stallion grin on his face, and thinking maybe he'd show what mare what the meadow's for. But, but anyways, the great thing about a wonderful metaphor is you can decide what else it represents. In the black dust hills of East Tennessee, all the work's just about the same. You may not go to a job in the ground, but you'll learn a miner's refrain. I'm down in a hole, I'm down in a hole, I'm down in a deep dark hole. I'm down in a hole, I'm down in a hole, I'm down in a deep dark hole. Will you search the rain for a silver cloud and dream of days of gold? When you pitch to the bottom and the dirt crumbles around, you'll cry so cold, so cold. I'm down in a hole, I'm down in a hole, I'm down in a deep dark hole. Thank you. or the troubles in your soul. 'Cause a wearied man's been a long time down in a deep dark hole. I'm down in a hole. I'm down in a hole. I'm down in a deep dark hole. I'm down in a hole. I'm down in a hole. I'm down in a deep dark hole.
Thank you very much. Y'all are real kind. Appreciate you doing this and everything. I realize that the lights is real bright and everything, but I wanted to say this is the best television place I ever been. I'm speaking now just to people like me that works for a living. This is the only time I ever been in one where they never made us put on no makeup. The last one, I hid in the broom closet till 15 seconds for, and what good would it do? You guys out there watching, just think, well, what could we change? You know, it'd be like iffy, like one of them surgeries where you might do more harm than good. And speaking of which, you know, people like us could wear out a crew of plastic surgeons getting ready for television. I believe some rock and roll singers have tried that approach. But this studio, they didn't do that, and I really appreciate it, because think what it's like to be a rancher. Eventually, you're going to get your tractor caught in the ditch, and you might have to call one of the farmers or ranchers around the neighborhood to come hook a chain up to you and pull you out, and you know what's going to happen. They'll be down there having coffee 5:30 in the morning. You're going to go get the guy that wore the makeup? Oh, not me. Maybe we could send one of our wives.
Oh, thank you.
cardboard suitcase and a four-year-old beauty. Ain't this a heck of a life? In their hot Texas farm roads, quality footwear, me with three kids and a wife. In their rows, it ain't easy, cause I do get lonesome, and I know it's a sad thing to say. It's easy forgetting your wife and your family when you're 500 miles away. In their rows, if you hear me, and try to forgive me, cause I feel it coming on me again. Come Saturday night, I'll be in El Paso with Carolyn at the Broken Leaf Inn. Kids all need new shoes again. Well, God darn my soul, I spend $20 on Carol at the Broken Wheel Inn. Now, Rose, if you hear me, try to forgive me, cause I feel it coming on me again. Come Saturday night, I'll be in El Paso with Carol.
Water rising so damn fast, thought it'd drown us all.
steers that day and four or five good mounds. When all the boys rode into camp, we knew that's what counts, and we'd sing whoopee-tie-yi-yay and Amazing Grace. For the time they broke behind us and they took us by surprise, I whistled out to Bonner, saw the terror in his eyes. And he rode for all his horse could ride. I know they'd done their best, but he crossed over Jordan, riding Dunny to his death. And we sing, bringing in the sheaves and the rugged cross.
Like the old clock on the wall has caught up with us, and it's time to pack up our gear and get out of here and let another fine program come on. Thank you so much for watching. We really appreciate that. And we appreciate the cards and letters and emails and telephone calls, whatever. We really appreciate those, folks. It makes this all worthwhile. And we want to thank our people behind the scenes, our whole crew. There's a bunch of them, so I can't name all of them. Until next time, this is DJ Davenport wishing you and yours the very, very best. And take care of one another. You couldn't take care of nicer people.